What's up, King Creator fans? Today will be a day with lots of inventions, as I'm feeling quite creative. To start with, we'll need a motor and a plastic propeller. Of course, we'll need a switch to start the motor. And that's the entire electrical circuit. First, connect a black wire to one pin, and the black wire from the snap to the next pin. Tic Tacs? Put some instant glue on top of the container and attach the motor and propeller. Apply more glue to the base and glue it to the part of the drill that you see on the screen. We should have taken the mints out of the container before all of this. Why didn't I think of that before? We'll need some bottles of bubbles for this invention. You can also create your own by combining water and soap if you want to save some money. Get a container from the kitchen. Empty all the bubbly liquid we need into it. My sister once had to be taken to the hospital when she was little because she drank this liquid. We knew from a young age that she had problems. It must be completely filled. Once filled, close it with the lid to avoid accidents. Take the toilet paper that you use to wipe your patootie with, butt expression, and clean the liquid residue from the bubble wands. We will need 6 of them in total. So on second thought, it's better you buy them. Cut off the lower part of all of them, making sure they are the same size. With our super glue, join the bubble wands in the center, forming this extraterrestrial symbol. That I've seen more than once. Aliens! Attach a wooden stick to our new alien symbol and secure it with some thread on the string. Pass the string around all the sticks and wrap it several times around. Doing this reminds me of when I used to play with my spinning top. I was pretty good. Apply a little glue all over the string to turn it into a stone. Finally, insert the complete mechanism into the drill hole and tighten it well. Don't let anyone tell you that you can't blow 100 bubbles per second. I would have given anything to have one of these as a child. The next invention is even shorter than the previous one and involves this metal syringe tip. Cut the end of the base and the tip with a hacksaw. Once we have the body of our blowpipe, get a nail from one of your mom's paintings and insert it into the blowpipe. Find the best rubber band you have at home and cut it with scissors. This will serve as a slingshot when placed on the nail. Secure it with colored adhesive tape, which will wrap around the whole thing. Now, if we both pull the nail and rubber band, it will generate a spring effect when we release it, launching whatever we put inside. While we're on the subject of firepower, I'll show you what I'll be using. Remove the wheel since we'll need what it scrapes against to generate a spark. Does someone remember the name of this? Insert it, and that's it. Just heat up the blowpipe opening and pull both the nail and rubber band to see a show of sparks. It even lights up the whole room for a few seconds. Just don't point it at flammable things because you know what could happen. The popsicles are back. What? Did you think I could make a video without them? Let's be honest, the channel wouldn't be the same without them. Take your precious box cutter and remove the razor. We'll need 2 of them. The next step involves our super glue to attach the razor to the popsicle stick. Of course, since there are 2 of them, we'll need to repeat the previous step once more. Once we have our 2 Deadpool knives, the next thing we need to do is take out our mini pocket knife and create a hole in both pieces as indicated by the blades. Place one on top of the other as you see on the screen, and impale them with a hot dog skewer. I just made myself hungry. It reminds me of my first time at camp in elementary school. I was with my grandfather at the school soccer field. He bought some special hot dogs that were stuffed with cheese. Delicious! After impaling and cutting, file down the piece of wood protruding from the hole. Take 3 bottle caps that you find on the ground. And with the help of the box cutter, remove the center part. Put glue on one of the popsicle sticks and attach 2 of the caps to it. Aren't they great scissors? Get the last cap on the opposite side. And finally, add a rubber band giving it 2 twists just before the handles. Ready! Now you have the sharpest and most powerful scissors in school, not to mention that they're easy to make. In case one day you can't buy some at the office supply store, the arts and crafts girl will envy you. It is also useful for cutting fabrics and creating your own princess dresses. I was once threatened with a pair of scissors, but that's a story for another time. Only 2 more inventions to go today. Yes, there have been quite a few. 5 inventions in a single video is a record. Take the cap of a Pringles container and create a hole right in the center. Since we have some leftover box cutter blades, we'll use 3 of them. Cut off the pieces with the hole. Now we'll need a pointed wooden stick. Apply super glue at different heights to attach the blades to it. Make sure that each one points a different way. Aren't they beautiful? Put the stick with multiple knives inside the Pringles can and cover it by putting the lid onto the stick. Once it looks like this, make a mark where we will need to cut it with the saw. Find some colored straws and cut a short piece from one of them. Take apart one of your brother's toys and get this L-shaped motor. Place glue on one of its pivots and place the straw piece there. Then insert it into the hole in the lid and secure it with lots of super glue. Then, insert the stick with blades into the rest of the straw, and we'll have made most of the homemade food processor. Close the container and proceed to the super fun electrical circuit that everyone already knows. Make the necessary connections so that everything works as it should. One last connection with extra red wire. And finally, the power supply that is connected to the snap. To organize it, glue the battery to the motor and the switch to the battery. Food processor at work. The time has come to try it out. And for that, let's use an onion. First, peel the onion. Onions have layers. Remember Shrek? Once peeled, look for a knife, razor, or axe to split it in half. Take one of the halves and remove its tail. Cut it in 4 parts so that it can fit inside our mini food processor. Put 2 of the pieces in and close the lid. Simply turn it on and let it do its job. See how each piece gets smaller and smaller? Say goodbye to chopping onions. I will never again be told that I can't cut vegetables well. And above all, I will no longer cry when I do it. And not just because of onions. It came out perfect. Look how finely chopped it is. There's still one more to go, the last one of the day. And yes, I will explain it to you in the last 40 seconds. Run! Cut off the excess of the wooden stick so that the bridge is this short. Take your mighty drill and connect it to the wheel. What do you mean you already used your drill for the first invention? You don't have 2? If we press the switch, the wheel will start to rotate as fast as a Lamborghini's wheels. And that's exactly what we'll do with this skateboard. Secure the drill well under the skateboard and use a lot of industrial grade tape to prevent it from falling off. Catch me if you can. I've been wanting to trade in my old car for something cooler, and I think this is the most aerodynamic option. Well, I'll see you at the finish line. Thanks for watching our inventions made out of household items today. Follow my channel if you'd like to learn more about making simple yet incredible inventions. Also, click on the link to see more videos about my amazing inventions. Click on the link to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any of my videos. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial.